It's a brand new day, a brand new story. I remember the way it used to be. We've come so far. You're my history, you're my beginning. In all I've done, I've been nurtured in your arms, and you've carried me this far. I want to sing a song for Singapore. With every generation, there's more to be grateful for. So come and sing a song for Singapore. You're my brother, you're my sister. I'm thankful for my Singapore.
Broken chair in an empty room. I came from the dream time, from the dusty red soil plains. I am the ancient heart, the keeper of the plain. I stood upon the rocky shores, I watched the tall ships come. For 40,000 years I've been the first Australian. I came upon the prison ship, bowed down by iron chains. I fought the land, endured the lash, and waited for the rains. I'm a settler, I'm a farmer's wife on a dry and barren run. A convict, then a free man, I became Australian.
I'm the daughter of a digger who sold the mother lode. The girl became a woman on the long and dusty road. I'm a child of the depression.
I saw the good times come.
I'm a bushy, I'm a bamber. I am Australia.
We are one.
But we are family. I am, you are, we are Australian.
I'm a teller of stories, I'm a singer of songs. I am Albert Mamajira, and I paint the ghostly gums. I'm Clancy on his horse, I'm Ned Kelly on the run. I'm the one who waltzed Matilda, I am Australia.
I'm the hot wind from the desert, I'm the black soil of the plains. I'm the mountains and the valleys, I'm the drought and flooding rain. I am the rock, I am the sky,
the rivers when they run, the spirit of this great land. I am Australian. We are one.
I bet you're weak. the ground, lay your money down. It's a gambling town, you better watch out if you think you're winning. On a pension day when the old and gray ask what would I say in the gambling.
Pigram on the rhythm guitar, folks. David Pigram on the rhythm. Peter Pigram on the bass. Gavin Pigram on the percussion. Philip Pigram on the drums. Alan Pigram on all things electric and lead. Thank you very much.
And Stephen Pigram in the middle.
Galea.
G'day, g'day. How you going? Isn't it great to be an Aussie, taking a walk along the street, looking in shops or buying a paper, stopping and having a yarn with people that you meet down at the pub or at a party, whenever you're stuck for what to say. If you want to be dinky-dye, why don't you give it a try? Look 'em right in the eye and say good day.
Good day, good day. How you going? What do you know? Well, strike a light. Good day, good day. And how you going? Just say good day, good day, good day, and you'll be right. Now when Italians meet, they all go crazy. The blokes all like to hug each other too. The Yanks invented hi and see you later, while the pommy will shake your hand and say how do you do. Now watch out for a Frenchman or he'll kiss you. The Spaniards go for hola and ole. Eat an Aussie 10-1, here's what he'll say. G'day, g'day. How you going? What do you know? Well, strike a light. G'day, g'day. And how you going? Just say g'day, 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 and you'll be right. It's a greeting that you'll hear across Australia, from Geraldton to Govan Gundigai. It's as dinkum as the dingo and the dahlia, and you spell it with a G apostrophe, a D-A-Y. Good day, good day. How you going? What do you know? We'll strike a light. Good day, good day. And how you going? Just say good day, good day, good day, and you'll be right. Good day, good day. And how you going? What do you know? We'll strike a light. Good day, good day. And how you going? Just say good day, good day, good day. Just say good day, good day, good day, and she'll be right.
Right. out of the blue.
Call me a drover, but God only knows how long it has been since I last hit the road. Sold all the horses, the blue dog is dead, and the rats are devouring the gear in the shed. My bridle and stock whip now hang on the wall, and I doubt if I ever will use them at all. My spurs and my quart pot I'll not use again. Oh, you don't need such trappings when droven by train. Droven by train, droven by train. You don't need such trappings when droven by train. Don't need a pack horse to carry my swag. No need to be careful to balance the bag. This battered old esky will hold all I need, and a rusty tin opener will get me a feed. How long has it been since I last sang a tune, while riding around by the light of the moon? I doubt if I'll ever ride night watch again. Oh, you don't do much singing when droven by train. Droven by train, droven by train. You don't do much singing when droven by train. This dirty old rattling and lurching KB ain't exactly the latest in sweet luxury. There ain't any carpets or tiles on the floor, and the paintwork and curtains don't match the decor. Well, I stand at the door and I gaze up the track, and I think of those cattle and there's no turning back. Oh, the rattle of brakes is their farewell refrain. They're going to slaughter and traveling by train. Droven by train, droven by train. They're going to slaughter and traveling by train. I pulled into a station and screamed at the guard, oh, just how long will we stand in this yard? I've 10 bullocks down and I can't get them up. Oh, for God's sake, get moving or I'll lose the lot. The battery is finished, the jigger is dead. All I can think of is home and a bed. I run down the track and I race back again. Oh, I've had a gutful of droven by train. Droven by train, droven by train. Oh, I've had a gutful of droven by train. We're moving once more and I lie on my swag, and I think of those bullocks and dusty old stags. At least I got room to lie down and spread out, but those poor dreary cattle get more knocked about. When I think of those bullocks, it humbles my pride to think of them taking that last final ride. Just like this old drover, they're going. Melbourne by train, and I doubt if we'll ever see Gidgee again. Droving by train, I doubt if we'll ever see Gidgee again.
A jolly swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of a coolabah tree. He sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. He sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Down came a jumbuck to drink at the billabong. Up jumped the swagman and grabbed him with glee. He sang as he shoved that jumbuck in his tucker bag. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. He sang as he shoved that jumbuck in his tucker bag. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. A
Up rode the squatter, mounted on his thoroughbred. Up rode the troopers, one, two, three. With the jolly jumbuck that you got in your tucker bag, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. With the jolly jumbuck that you got in your tucker bag, you'll come a waltzing, you scoundrel, with me. Up jumped the swagman, sprang into the billabong. You'll never take me alive, said he, and his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. His ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with everybody. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. His ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Train. Cowboy, I hardly know the meaning of your term. Though fancy truckin' driving, day by day I'm striving for another job and another quid to earn. My rig would be the best along these highways. In confidence I mention this to you. With my fingertip selectors and computerized injectors, I'm a 1980s bushman on the move. Oh, you've never seen me in expensive moleskins. These Cuban heels I hardly can afford. But I'm content to get along in a dusty pair of battered thongs. Hey, look, this fancy t-shirt beats them all. Oh, I dig the homely beat of country music and the honest story in a country song. And my wheels are softly ringing to a country favorite singing while this 1980s bushman rolls along. Old granddad worked these highways many years ago. I guess we'd think those years were pretty mean. On the roughest track and byway, he shaped the future highway with Gray and Scoop and Grader and his team. Oh, if only he were here to see the progress. I wonder if the old man would approve of the... Oh, yeah. Carol's waiting. In the morning she'll be watching for the rig. She'll be laughing in the evening, be crying when I'm leaving, standing there a-waving with the kids. Oh, I often wonder, is it really worth it? Does my woman understand why I must roam? With these steering stabilizers, all the faster I can drive her, I'm a 1980s bushman going home. Sun across the lonely west is blazing, and the night that follows me is coming fast. There's a super snooper growling, there's a mobile raider prowling. It looks as though I found the bears at last. Oh, I wonder if they think that I'm a cow. With my gleaming chimneys glinting, the tone of road slave hinting of a 1980s bushman on the move.
Strangers to the show. my friends would rust in my defense. In the middle, in the middle, in the middle of a dream, I lost my shirt, I pawned my ring. I've done all the dumb things. Yeah, I threw my hat into the ring. I've done all the dumb things. Never stops me from going through these things twice. I see the knives out, I turn my back. I hear the train coming, I stay right on that track. In the middle, in the middle, in the middle of a dream, I lost my shirt, I pawned my rings. I've done all the dumb things. I melted wax to fix my wings.
Back last week just to see for myself how different they are, this new crowd. The tourists ain't welcome and signs scream at you, no camping, no fires allowed. I remember those rides where the black wattle grew, when you mustered for Branders with me, where the scrub was so thick a blue dog couldn't bark. Well, I tell you, it's something to see. They've cleared it, fenced it, and sorghum is sown. These fellows know how to grow grain. Headers and harvesters, fencing and sheds, and there's silos and Ivanhoe Plain. Old Ivanhoe's gone and the plough has moved in. Big tractors have pulled all the scrub. But there's barley and wheat and a bitumen road, and they've pulled down the 40-mile pub. Where I stand, I can see the new dam changes as progress moves on. Hey! You won't find a campfire where often we yarn. The wild cattle have gone like the scrub. Like me, you won't stay when you see what they've done to this place and the 40-mile pub. Old Ivanhoe's gone like so many big runs, whether better or worse, I don't know. But it seems kinda strange to be told by this sign, no camping on old Ivanhoe. No camping on old Ivanhoe.
Ira, schoolboy coming home through fields of cane to a house of tin and timber in the sky. Rain of falling cinders from time to time, the waste, memory wastes. I recall a boy in bigger pants. Like everyone, he's learning how to dance. His father's watch, he left it in the shower. From time to time, the waste, memory waste, and the waste, memory waste. When shadows fall, you lose your time and place. When shadows fall, you lose your time and place. When shadows fall, you lose your time and place. When shadows fall, you lose your time and place. Well, I recall a bigger, brighter world, a world of books and silent times in thought. And then the railroad takes him home through fields of cattle, through fields of cane. From time to time, the waste, memory waste, and the waste, memory waste.
I recall the same. He replied, "What's the plan that you once had?" And it went from time down to mine. Well, that time was bad, so I knew where I was. I was alone, and I was so far from my own home.
Further, longer, higher, older.
In the scrub and settled on a bar stool down in Joe McGuire's pub. From the moment that I walked in there and bought myself a beer, I felt at ease and welcome in a friendly atmosphere. For the bar is plain and simple, there's no tiles or polished brass, and the customers are mostly of the solid working class. The old pub gets overcrowded every sale day in the town, when the auctioneers and squatters and the stockmen gather round. The arrangement of the bottles on the shelf behind the bar may not be in order like some fancy hotels are. And his way of keeping banknotes in a sack of calico would be scoffed at by accountants, but it seems all right with Joe. Now Joseph has arranged it to the audience's delight, country music playing in the lounge on Friday night. Oh, the entertainers may not get a hearing in a club, but the drinkers sure applaud them down in Joe McGuire's pub. Now young Patrick and the bar staff serve you with a pleasant smile, and Joseph runs the old place in a free and easy style. And if you're in town, try their tucker,
Old mate, it's first class grub. And you know the beer's 1 cent cheaper down at Joe McGuire's pub. Oh, he's been around a long time, he'll be around a long time yet. And he runs the kind of pub I like, and so will you, I bet. So I tell you, fellow bushman, when you're in town from the scrub, oh, you'll really find a welcome down in Joe McGuire's pub. Yes, I wandered into Tamworth from a station in the scrub and settled on a bar stool down in Joe McGuire's pub. From the moment that I walked in there and bought myself...
Station, for the word had passed around that the colt from Old Regret had got away and had joined the Wild Bush Horses. He was worth £1,000, so all the cracks had gathered to the fray. All the tried and noted riders from the stations near and far had mustered at the homestead overnight, for the bushmen love hard riding where the Wild Bush Horses are, and the stock horse snuffs the battle with delight. There was Harrison, who made his pile when Pardon won the cup, and the old man with his hair as white as snow. But few could ride beside him when his blood was fairly up. He would go wherever horse or man could go. And Clancy of the Overflow came down to lend a hand. No better horseman ever held the reins, for never horse could throw him while the saddle girths would stand. And he learned to ride while droving on the plains. And one was there, a stripling, on a small and weedy beast. He was something. He was hard and tough and wiry, just the sort that won't say die. There was courage in his quick, impatient tread, and he bore the badge of gameness in his bright and fiery eye, and the proud and lofty carriage of his head. But still so slight and weedy, one would doubt his power to stay. And the old man said, "That horse will never do. For a long and tiring gallop, lad, you'd better stop away. Those hills are far too rough for such as you." So he waited sad and wistful, lonely Clancy stood his friend. "Oh, I think we ought to let him come," he said. "And I warrant he'll be with us when he's wanted at the end. For both his horse and he are mountain bred. Oh, he hails from Snowy River, up by Kosciuszko's side, where the hills are twice as steep and twice as rough, where a horse's hooves strike firelight from the flintstones every stride, and the man that holds his own is good enough. And the Snowy River riders on the mountains make their home, where the river runs those giant hills between. I have seen full many horsemen since I first commenced to roam, but no way yet such horsemen have I seen." So he went, they found the horses by the big mimosa clump. They raced away towards the mountain's brow, and the old man gave his orders, "Boys, go at 'em from the jump. No use to try for fancy riding now. And Clancy, you must wheel them, try and wheel them to the right, and ride boldly, lad, and never fear the spills. For never yet was rider that could keep that mob in sight, if once they gained the shelter of those hills." So Clancy rode to wheel them. He was racing on the wing, where the best and boldest riders take their place. And he raced his stock horse past them, and he made the rangers ring with his stock whip as he met them face to face. Then they halted for a moment while he swung the dreaded lash, but they saw their well-beloved mountain full in view. And they charged beneath the stock whip with a sharp and sudden dash, and off into the mountain scrub they flew. Then past the horsemen followed, where the gorges deep and black resounded to the thunder of their tread. And the stock whips woke the echoes, and they fiercely answered back from cliffs and crags that beetled overhead. And upward, ever upward, the wild horses held their way, where Currajong and mountain ash grew wide. And the old man muttered fiercely, "We may bid the mob good day. No man could hold them down the other side." When they reached the mountain summit, even Clancy took a pull. It well might make the boldest hold their breath. The wild hop scrub grew thickly, and the hidden ground was full of wombat holes, and any slip was death. But the man from Snowy River let the pony have his head, and he swung his stock whip round and gave a cheer. And he raced him down the mountain like a torrent down its bed, while the others stood and watched in very fear. He sent the flintstones flying, but the pony kept his feet. Oh, he cleared the fallen timber in his stride. And the man from Snowy River never shifted in his seat. It was grand to see that mountain horseman ride through the stringy box and saplings on the rough and broken ground. Down the hillside at a racing pace he went, and he never drew the bridle till he landed safe and sound at the bottom of the terrible descent. He was right among the horses as they climbed the farther hill, and the watchers on the mountain standing mute. Saw him ply the stockwhip fiercely, he was right among them still, as he raced across the clearing in pursuit. Then they lost him for a moment, where two mountain gullies met, in the ranges over the final glimpse reveals. On a dim and distant hillside, the wild horses racing yet, with the man from Snowy River at their heels. And he ran them single-handed till their sides were white with foam. He followed like a bloodhound on their track, till they halted cowed and beaten, then he turned their heads for home, and alone and unassisted brought them back. But his hardy mountain pony, he could scarcely raise a trot. He was blood from hip to shoulder from the spur. But his pluck was still undaunted and his courage fiery hot, for never yet was mountain horse a cur. And down by Kosciuszko, where the pine-clad ridges raise their torn and rugged battlements on high, where the air is clear as crystal and the white stars fairly blaze at midnight in the cold and frosty sky, and where around the overflow the reed beds sweep and sway to the breezes and the rolling plains are wide. Oh, the man from Snowy River is a household word today, and stockmen tell the story of his ride. And stockmen tell the story of his ride. And stockmen tell the story of his ride. And stockmen tell the story of his ride.
Right on at 7 o'clock on a Monday morning for a cup of coffee, better make it a strong one. When the man on the radio says it's gonna rain and it's gonna blow, it'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. Australia marched out of Vietnam, out in the streets against Uncle Sam, and we won the long one. Uranium demo the other day, one of my mates got dragged away. If they slammed the door, I heard her say, it'll be alright in the long run. And bloke who works with me, and we squabble laugh and company, and he slapped me on the back, said, you're wrong, son. This isn't the land I was told it'd be. It's not so equal and not so free. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. It'll be alright, it'll be alright, it'll be alright in the long run. Shadows the economic scream, sheer as curse, the people dream. We've taken some right turns, they've been the wrong one. Ships leave and the headlines blaze. Australia remembers happier days. Back there's on within the haze. It'll be alright in the long run. Sitting in camp and you stare at the fire. The doubts drop away as the hope gets higher, and you sing to yourself, it'll be alright. Feel alright in the long run. Long pole nine, you screw up your courage for another fight, but you know in your heart it'll be alright, be alright in the long run. The sun streams in with power and might, and you look at your kids in a different light, and you know in your heart as you kiss them goodnight, it'll be alright in the long run.
it's a lonesome away from your kindred and all. By the campfire at night, hear the wild dingoes call. But there's a nothing so lonesome, morbid or drear, than to stand in the bar of a pub with no beer. Now the publican's anxious for the quota to come, and there's a faraway look on the face of the bum. The maid's gone all cranky and the cook's acting queer. Oh, what a terrible place is a pub with no beer. Well, strange things happen here in the outback. My old friend who wrote that song is here with all our truckie mates today. Let's give a big hand as he comes out with his guitar to the yodeling bushman, Gordon Parsons, my old mate. Hiya, Jack. There's nothing I wouldn't do for Ned, and there's nothing he wouldn't do for me. And that's how we go through life, doing absolutely nothing for each other.
Right, thank you.
Would you like
much.
To sing along in this? You can do the next verse you like about the stockman. Hey!
While the stockman rides in with his dry, dusty throat, he breasts up to the bar, pulls a wad from his coat. The smile on his face quickly turns to a sneer as the barman said sadly, the pub's got no beer.
Then the swaggy comes in, smothered in dust and flies. He throws down his roll and rubs the sweat from his eyes. But when he is told, he says, what's this I hear? I've trudged 50 flaming miles to a pub with no beer.
Hey, there's a dog on the verandah for his master. He waits, cause the boss is inside drinking wine with his mates.
Terrible situation.
He hurries for cover and he cringes in fear.
Yeah.
What a place for a dog in a pub with no beer.
And old Billy the blacksmith, the first time in his life, has gone home cold sober to his darling wife. He walks in the kitchen, she says, you're early, Bill dear. But then he breaks down and tells her, the pub's got no beer. Shall we waltz all together? Hey,
it's a lonesome away from your kindred and all. By a campfire at night, where the wild dingoes call.
But there's nothing so lonesome, morbid or drear, than to stand in the bar of that pub with a no beer. No.
Thank you.
looking forward, looking back. I've come a long way down the track, got a long way left to go, making songs from what I know, making sense of what I've seen. All the love we've had between you and I along the track, looking forward, looking back. There are strange days full of change on the way, but we'll be fine. Unlike some, I'll be leaning forward to see what's coming. Looking forward, looking back. I've come a long way down the track, got a long way left to go, making songs what I know. If I'm alone at night, I can see through all triviality of the day, and I'm okay. I just think of those who are dear to me. Looking forward, looking back. I've come a long way down the track, got a long way left to go, making songs from what I know, making songs from what I know. Looking forward, looking
I realize it's a wide open road. wide open road. It's a reach I just approach you. It's wide open road. Then I realize it's a wide open road.
Winding back to an old-fashioned shack along the road to Gundagai, where the gum trees are growing and the Murrumbidgee's flowing beneath the sunny sky. There's my mother and daddy awaiting for me, and the pals of my childhood once more I will see. And no more will I roam, 'cause I'm heading right for a home along the road to Gundagai. For a home along the road to Gundagai. Here we go.
Well, I've walked a mile or two in my lifetime, and I've traveled down some muddy tracks and drive. 'Cause if I wanted to get where I was going, I knew I'd just have to walk that country mile. Now a country mile would be the longest distance a man could ever travel when he's down. But you just don't give up easy anymore. And I've walked a mile or two in my lifetime, and I've traveled down some muddy tracks and drive. 'Cause if I wanted to get where I was going, I knew I'd just...
And that long mile has shown me changes, changes in the people and the land. But I'll bet the road to Marble Bar's no better than when I drove with trucks and caravans. And the country bloke is still the same old battler, no matter what the place he's working in. And although I've covered many miles, I still can't wait to see what the next one country mile will bring. Well, I've walked a mile or two in my lifetime, and I've traveled down some muddy tracks and dry. 'Cause if I wanted to get where I was going, I knew I'd just have to walk that country mile. Yes, I knew I'd have to walk that country mile.
Thank you very much, everyone. Back in those days, back in 43, it was don't call us, we'll call you. So I did for about five years, I tormented them. And then in 1946, I got the chance to come back for another audition, and I was accepted this time on that fabulous old Regal Xenophone label. And back in those days, every song had to contain a yodel. I put this particular song down a bit over 45 years ago now, and I put it straight down without a yodel. And the supreme command of the man in charge said, you have to do it again. There's no yodel. So I made one up on the spot. I've never done that yodel since. It was so terrible. So after 45 years, here it is once again. The old rain tumbles down in July.
Summery sunshine has flown, where the logs tangle up on the creek beds, and clouds veil the old northern sky, and the cattle move back from the lowlands, when the rain tumbles down in July. The settlers with sad hearts are watching the rise of the stream from the dawn. Their best crops are always in flood rates. If it rises much more, they'll be gone. The cattle string out along the fences, and the wind from the south races by, and the limbs from the old gums are falling when the rain tumbles down in July. The sleeping gums on the hillside awaken to herd straying by, from the flats where the fences have vanished, as the storm clouds gather on high. Of the wagon stop turning, the stock horse is turned out to stray, the old station dogs are a-dozing on the husks in the barn through the day. The drover draws rein by the river, and it's years since he's seen it so high. Yes, and that's just a story of homeward when the rain tumbles
anything but good. That we'd never see you stranded, we'd do the best we could. Hey, we'd push them through the cities, from coast to coast and back. We'd drive the mighty semis, the Volvo and the Mac. Oh, it may not be the brightest one, this job we have to do, but still there must be someone to get the semis through. Hey, we take them through the country, we push them constantly. We drive the mighty semis, the Merc and BMC. Oh, the miles are long and many, and the comfort short and few, but the wheels are kept a-rolling to get the cargo.
Don't seem all that long ago. Here's my own son, thinking the same, itching to get himself into the game. He won't understand when I try to explain, though it's not what it used to be. 'Cause he's riding on diesel in dreams, down a highway that runs through his mind, behind the wheel of the biggest rig he's ever seen. He's riding on diesel in dreams, behind the wheel of the biggest rig he's ever seen. He's riding on diesel in dreams.
Top end, where you gotta know your job and what you're doing each day. On 2 million acres, you bet you'll have to earn your pay. If you want to take it on, there's one thing that shouldn't be forgotten. Nobody else can do the job like a ringer from the top end. Out on the fence line, swallowing dust, blood on my hands from the bar, hoping that road bull won't see the hole before they get him in the yard. But I get a funny feeling in the middle of my back, sure enough he's coming like a train down the track. That's when nobody else moves faster than the swinger from the top end.
Look out now!
You gotta muster 3,000 head in a day, moving to the yards and water them at end of day. It's not the sort of job you'd take if you're looking for a soft one, but you take a kind of pride in saying I'm a ringer from the top end. Well, I roll out my swag neath a Boab tree, and then I'm out like a light, dreaming about those girls in town. Next thing is broad daylight. No time to dream of what might have been. I'm in a dirty bull catcher with a muster and team. I'd better keep my mind on the job, 'cause I'm a ringer from the top end.
Hey!
And nobody does the job better than a ringer from the top end.
So are you tough enough for me?